We've looked at a lot of the products within the MK base range, but today we're going to focus in on the dimmer switch because we think it's got a feature that you'll love.
I saw the sign, it opened up my eyes, I saw the sign.
Was that Ace of Base?
It was Ace of Base, and in this series of videos we've been doing looking at the bass range from MK, every time the scrolls come in I've tried to give a song linked to the word bass.
Well, I hope there's not many videos left in these series. I don't know how much more I can stand of this. We have looked at the products before. We'll put a link for the full MK bass range in the description. If you haven't seen any of those, there are some great products in there. But today we're looking at dimmers, Gary. And we're going to start with what I would term the low end.
Okay, so explain what low end is on the rig behind us. It's okay. A lovely looking rig as well.
Yeah, it's nothing to do with the quality of the dimmer. It's to do with the light level when you've turned the dimmer down. So we've built this rig here that's got these rather fetching conduit lamps. And Gary, did you make these yourself?
I did, yes. There'll be a short video out. Make sure you check that one out.
Yeah, we have. And we've paired them as well with some 5-amp sockets. It's a great tip if you want to, if you're doing a rewire, put a few of these in a room so the customer can come along and plug in wall lights or table lamps and things like that. So that's a good combination. But when I mean low end, Garrett, I'm going to turn this lamp down to its lowest setting.
Okay. Is that it?
At the moment, yes.
Ah, right, okay. So we didn't have a lot of dimming there. So we've come all the way to a certain point and it's stopped the dimming process.
Yeah, and it's a trait of LED lamps. There's a bit of compromise in LED lamps. It's a case of matching your lamp to your dimmer.
Right.
But built into most LED dimmers is the feature to trim this low end.
Yeah.
Now let's just remind ourselves, because the rig in front of us here we built when we did our Great British Dim Off series, we found that there's two ways of setting that low end, isn't there, Gary?
Yeah, we've got to get the potentiometer in one of them. So that means we've got to take the front off and live, actually adjust it down to trim that lower end. Or the other one, let's exaggerate it slightly, you have to sort of stand on one leg, tap the back of your head, press the button, rotate it full, rotate it back, press it twice more, and it went into like a pairing mode for that low end.
Okay, so let's just unpack that a little bit, Gary. I've got the scenario, you've wired the house here, could be a new build, rewire. Customer's moved in, they've changed the light fitting.
Right.
You'll be getting the call soon about the loop in, loop out wiring, so you can help them out there. But they want to set the low end,
right,
which is setting that low end dim level. That first scenario, they've got to pull the switch off the wall.
Yeah.
Probably you could damage the decoration, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah.
But trim that potentiometer with it live.
Yeah, and who's to say they've got an insulated screwdriver? You're probably not going to recommend that one, are you?
No. And then that second version, they've lost the instructions that you didn't leave with them in the first place.
And then I've got to remember what those instructions said myself, and I probably haven't got a set either. Of course, that's going to be difficult. I know what's going to happen. You're going to end up jumping in your van, and you're going to have to drive out just because the dimming pattern doesn't suit the client, does it?
Yeah, well, MK have solved that with this product, Gary.
Okay.
Yeah, now it's a simple innovation.
I like simple innovations.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready for it.
They've put the low-end potentiometer on the front panel.
Ah, right, okay. So you just start with that with your screwdriver.
Yeah, so you don't have to remove it. You don't have to twiddle the switch 20 times. So I'm going to do it now. I've got this lamp here. You can see it's dims nice and beautiful and smoothly, but personally I'd want a lower end setting on there. I'll just twiddle that with the screwdriver. You can see that comes down. I mean, I can dim to off.
Okay.
But personally, I just like to leave it at the lowest possible. There you go. And just set a glimmer of light there. And then I can dim that nice up again. I can dim that back down to a nice smooth level, turn off, turn it back on again, and then we're at that level. So I think that's...
I think I could instruct somebody over a phone on how to do that.
That was easy. And then there is the screw cap you can just put over that. If you want to seal that off, if you don't want the customer meddling with it, you can put that over there and watch out for our top tip on how to remove that.
Yeah, a little bit of duct tape, just wipe it over the top of it, pull it off. It's not an issue. It's not a, let's not put the caps on because of that. I think the caps go back on. They're ever so easy to get off, aren't they?
Yeah, so we've paired this dimmer. People asked us when we looked at GU10 lamps what dimmers are like when it comes to this very popular style of incandescent lamp, which is obviously LED.
I was going to say, it's not an incandescent lamp, it's an LED lamp. If you can get hold of an incandescent lamp, I'd be very surprised nowadays.
Yeah, but it's LED, so these are incredibly popular. This dimmer works fantastically with this, but what's it like with other types of lamp source we have in the home?
Okay.
First off, I've married up some LED strip.
An LED strip that's dimmable. I don't think we've covered that so far on the channel.
Yeah, so we've actually dimmed this through a LED driver that's suitable for use with phase control dimmers.
Ah, so if I've got a standard driver for my LED tape, the likelihood is I can't dim it, can I?
No, but this is a special one, and we will look at that in a separate video about how that driver performs.
Okay.
But it's just mains in, out to your LED tape, low voltage, and then coupled to this
and
dimmer.
And you're able to dim it, yeah?
Yep, so you can see it's up there. Dimming there, you can see there.
Yeah.
It's dimmed down, but again, I think we can go lower.
Okay, so you're going to trim that low end?
Just going to trim that low end.
So if we look at that, yeah. Wow.
And there you go. So I think that's pretty good performance there.
And that's straight out of the box.
So we
just wire the switches we would normally, in this case it's a dimmer, we take our terminal screwdriver and we can just adjust that low end.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, and then on the bench in front we've got some GU10 lamps. Now again, as we always say, LED dimming is about compromise. We tend to find if you buy a better quality lamp, you get better performance dimming. So it's not just about the dimmer switch, it is about that. So we've got the lamp behind us is one we got from Philips.
Right.
These are also some Philips GU10 lamps.
Okay.
So and you can see again.
Let's bring that in so we have a look there.
I've got our low end setting on here. I can trim that down and go, yep.
So wow.
That's a setting I'm happy with. Dim that up, I get great performance. Now, just to demonstrate that, I'm going to swap these out for a little bit more budget lamp.
Okay, and that sort of flies in the face of it a little bit. We're looking at effectively the base range from MK is sitting itself in that sort of budget end, but sometimes in installation you've got to buy maybe a quality lamp to get a quality performance. Would you agree with that, Gordon?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's time and time again we see it. I've changed those for some, more budget lamps.
You've got them on at all?
Yeah, okay, turn them on there. Yeah. But again, I'm going to turn out that low end. That's it.
That's as far as it goes.
I'll trim the low end a bit more. Yeah, that's it. So the low end cannot fix the problem with that. The only way to fix the dimming on there is to buy a better quality lamp.
Okay, so it trims it beautifully. Okay, that's a reasonably priced dimmer. Works brilliantly with the slightly more expensive lamps. But yeah, so that's a little bit of a compromise there with you. Managed to get a dim LED strip as well as LED incandescent style lamps, didn't we?
Yeah, and I think that's, you know, that covers most bases you would expect to find in most homes. The dimmer itself is rated for between 6 and 100 watts of LED lamp load.
Okay.
Yeah, you can also use it with halogen and incandescent lamps, but
if you can find any.
Yeah, they're not sold in the market anymore.
There is always a compromise, though. With anything, you know, there's always a compromise. What's the compromise with this MK-based one?
Okay, so the compromise on this is obviously to make room for that potentiometer there.
Yeah.
The dual gang version takes up, obviously, a twin socket box, a two gang box.
So we can't get two of the dimmers on a single box. We're in a twin box. Okay, that's fair enough.
And it is for one-way lighting control only. So you couldn't use it, say, on a staircase or where you've got two entrances into a room and you want the two-way switch.
And the depth of the box, can you just remind me of that?
They recommend a 35 millimeter box.
Okay, so the compromise is there, isn't it? So we've now got a twin box for the two gang. It's 35 mil deep.
Yeah, but let's remember some of these dimmers we looked at earlier have quite chunky faceplate, and one of the features we loved about the base when we looked at the other products in the range is there's a common depth of faceplate across the range.
There is. There's loads of great features in the MK base range, and like we said, we'll leave a link to that in the description for you to check those out and the video that we made on the range. But we're always interested in your feedback. Do you believe, like I do, that this trimming of the lower end by just using a terminal screwdriver on the potentiometer is actually going to make your life easier? Leave those comments below. Did you know about the MK base range? And there's something else in there that you want to talk about that has a standout feature? Leave them comments and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.
And feedback on Gary's singing.
I saw the sign, it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign.